Camden, New Jersey, the Sixers were right. The Sixers argued they should have set up at half-court, not court, for a decisive final possession of double overtime in Friday's game against the Thunder. After a closer look following their triple overtime loss, the NBA ruled the Sixers were proved correct. After review, it was determined that the 76ers called timeout with 0:01.2 remaining on the game clock, which was prior to Saric's fade dribble. Therefore, they should have been given the opportunity to advance the ball into their own front court for the inbound, the NBA officiating's last two-minute report noted. The confusion occurred at the end of the second overtime. Dario Saric got a defensive rebound and the Sixers called a timeout before he dribbled the ball. Because of this, the Sixers should have been allowed to set up a final play in the half court, which is exactly what they had practiced and called. But the referees made a last-second change as the Sixers were setting up. The Sixers were told they had to inbound from court, which would have been the case if Saric had dribbled before the timeout. The last two-minute report indicated he, in fact, did not respect that they are that transparent, but complete disappointment that it can happen, Brett Brown said Sunday. You really scratch your head. It's significant. Every play, every basket can make a difference for a team fighting to make the playoffs. The Sixers were confident they could have won the game with a half-court play. Instead, they dropped back down to 0.500 and currently 10 in the Eastern Conference. Those things you need to avoid to give yourself every chance to win, Brown said. We can point to many other things that were self-inflicted wounds that we've got to do better. When it's that exposed and that prominent of an environment with 1.2 seconds left, it's disappointing. But like I say, they're transparent. I respect the fact they admitted it and we move on. Camden, NJ. Joel Embiid does not play both games of a back-to-back, but whether he plays in either of the Sixers' next two matchups will have to be determined. Embiid is not traveling with the Sixers to Chicago for Monday's game against the suddenly streaking Bulls, who have won five straight. The big man usually plays at home in these scenarios, and considering he played 49 minutes in Friday's triple overtime loss, the decision was expected. Embiid's availability for Tuesday at home against the Kings, though, has not been finalized at this point. This is not surprising either, being 2 days ahead of the game. Embiid, who has been dealing with back tightness, did not participate in practice Sunday. The Sixers will evaluate, monitor, and go through treatment with Embiid before making the call. Unsure at this stage, Brett Brown said Sunday. I do know he's categorically out tomorrow and we're going to learn more about him being available when we come back for Sacramento, I'd expect in the next 24 hours. The Sixers do know they will be without another two players for some time. Trevor Booker will miss at least the next two games after suffering spraining his left ankle Friday. The newly acquired reserve will be re-evaluated in approximately 5 to 7 days. Even though Booker was traded to the Sixers less than 2 weeks ago, he already made an impact on the second unit. Brown has seen enough over the last four games to know what the team will be missing. His toughness, Brown said. He's got a motor. He plays with such a spirit. He's a man. He's a pro. He's been in the league for a while. He gets it. It's everything that you miss. It's really everything this team needs. Furk and Korkmaz likely will be sidelined even longer. The rookie suffered a Lisfranc injury on his left foot while playing for the Delaware 87ers on December 15 and is out indefinitely. The Sixers recalled Korkmaz from the G League and he is going through evaluation and testing. There is no timetable set for Korkmaz at this point. The American Academy of Orthopedic Surgeons described the injury as, Lisfranc midfoot injuries result if bones in the midfoot are broken or ligaments that support the midfoot are torn. The severity of the injury can vary from simple to complex, involving many joints and bones in the midfoot. Korkmaz has been going back and forth between the Sixers and their G League affiliate in Delaware to get playing opportunities as part of his development in his first NBA season. New York, Carmelo Anthony got the cheers, but the New York Knicks got the win, shutting out their former All-Star in the second half and beating the Oklahoma City Thunder 11,196 on Saturday night for their fourth straight victory. Michael Beasley tied his season high with 30 points in place of injured Kristaps Porzingis, and Doug McDermott, one of the players acquired for Anthony, added 11 of his 13 after halftime to help the Knicks break open the game. Anthony scored 12 points in the first half but was 0 for 5 after, perhaps low on energy after the Thunder's 3 overtime victory at Philadelphia a night earlier. He made a three-pointer for the Thunder's first basket of the game after a warm welcome back to the arena where he spent 12 years, finishing 5 of 18 from the field. Russell Westbrook had 25 points, 7 rebounds and 7 assists for the Thunder, who were trying to sweep a three-game trip that began with Paul George winning return to Indiana on Wednesday. See recap. LeBron James has 60th triple-double, Cavs beat Jazz Cleveland. LeBron James had 29 points, 11 rebounds and 10 assists for his 60th career triple-double and the Cleveland Cavaliers beat the short-handed Utah Jazz 109,100 on Saturday night. James had his 5th triple-double of the season and 3rd in his last 4 games. He had 10 points in the 4th quarter, was 9 of 15 from the field and 10 of 10 at the foul line. Cleveland has won 17 of 18 overall and 11 straight at Quicken Loans Arena. Center Rudy Gobert's sprained ligament and bone bruise in left knee and forward Derek Favors' left eye laceration were out for Utah. Both were injured during Friday night in a win in Boston. See recap. Former Sixer Kanan hits game-winning free throws in Suns win over 12 Minneapolis. Isaiah Kanan hit 3 free throws with 6 seconds to play in his first game with Phoenix and the Suns rallied to beat the Minnesota Timberwolves 108,106 on Saturday night. Added to the roster this week after the injury-ravaged Suns received a hardship extension, Kanan finished with 15 points and drew a foul on Jeff Teague on a 3-pointer with Minnesota leading by 1. Originally ruled a shot clock violation, reply officials overturned the call and Kanan calmly sank all 3 shots amid a loud crowd of neon green-clad fans. Alex Len blocked Jimmy Butler's layup attempt out of bounds on the ensuing possession. Butler had one more look from the corner, but the attempt rimmed out and the Suns snapped their 5-game losing streak. Dragan Bender and Troy Daniels each scored 17 points for the Suns, whose bench outscored the starters 6,939. T.J. Warren added 15 points for Phoenix, which trailed by as many as 15. See recap. Harden, Paul lead Rockets to 13th straight victory. Houston, James Harden scored 31 points, Chris Paul had 25 and the Houston Rockets beat the Milwaukee Bucks 115,111 on Saturday night for their 13th straight victory. The winning streak is the Rockets' longest streak since the franchise was 22 straight in 200,708. Harden hit a step-back three-pointer over Malcolm Brogdon and was fouled, giving Houston an 11-point lead with less than 6 minutes remaining. In the last 2 minutes, Paul hit back-to-back mid-range jumpers on consecutive possessions to put the game out of reach. Giannis Antetokounmpo had 28 points, 9 rebounds, 5 assists and 4 steals for Milwaukee. Chris Middleton had 23 points, and Brogdon added 20. Milwaukee has lost 3 straight. See recap.